thank you for that love. I always warn people when I start talking that words are like my third language. I am a movement-based speaker. Right? Home is this place where you are secure and loved and overprotected. And I spent a lot of time trying to get away from home so I could do stuff. So my first kind of major away adventure, I got through 4 years of undergrad in theater. Right? Yeah, thanks. And was like, ooh, what do you do now? Go to grad school in theater! So I pulled out the map and I decided I'm going to Chicago. And my parents kind of made a face. Are you sure you really want to go to Chicago? Mind you, my first 2 days on campus in undergrad, I had to call my dad to come pick me up. Because I had decided to take a little adventure while we were doing a service project and the bus left without me and a couple other people. So I had to eat a little crow when he pulled up and says, yeah, and you really wanted to go to the University of Hawaii, right? I was like, fine. But you know, I got through undergrad, right? So I was like 21, I had smart and I had known some stuff, so I was going to Chicago. So I went to Chicago at Roosevelt University and had all these really amazing adventures in the city, right? So I was like bold and daring, and I'm like, all right, I'm going on vacation. And not just any kind of vacation, grown-up vacation. So I call my good girlfriend, Katie. Now Katie is my miracle friend. Katie also went away for undergrad, and in her sophomore year at the University of Alaska, she got into this crazy accident that she should not have walked away from and actually ended up walking a mile and a half with a broken neck. God is good all the time. Anyway, so Katie, my miracle friend, has a couple of screws that kind of hold up her skull, because, you know, that's what happened. And she's just a little bit slower than she used to be. It's very important for later, so hold on to that piece of information. So I call Katie, I'm like, Katie, I think that we should go on grown-up vacation. And Katie was like, that's a good idea. My parents have this timeshare in Puerto Vallarta. It's funny because we're going on grown-up vacation and we're using her parents' timeshare. And they ended up coming with us because they didn't think we should be unsupervised outside of the country. But it was okay, because we had our own villa, and it was super cool, and we were, you know, international travelers then. So, we get to this beautiful, beautiful villa, and I'm walking around. Yeah, right, because it's beautiful. And we had this awesome pool. And at this awesome pool, there's this big old slide. And you slide down, and into the water. I was very, very excited. Well, there were two separate areas of this kind of property, and there was the family area where I witnessed, right, young people slide down into about 3-4 feet of water and stand up and run off and go do it again. Well, we had decided, since we were on grown-up vacation, that we were going to go to the adult secluded area where there was no lifeguard on duty. Okay. Slow friend, no lifeguard on duty. Okay, we're still there. Okay, so we're sitting there, and we're getting some sun. Well, Katie's really not getting sun because she's a redhead. So she has like SPF 40,000 and an umbrella. And saying something about wishing she was more chocolate, and I just laugh. But I look over, and there's a slide. I was like, oh yeah, I'm doing that. Katie, watch my stuff. I'm gonna hit this slide. All right, because you always sound cooler in your flashback, right? Okay, so I go walking up the little stairs, and I kind of, you know, adjust my swimsuit because I'm all international and who cares, right? And I go. Well, the Lord has blessed me with a very ample bottom, and when I hit that first curve, let's just say I was going much faster than I had anticipated. So when I hit the water, right, remember I walked past the little kitty family place I was expecting to into 4 feet of water, and then I was going to stand up. Did I mention I don't actually know how to swim at this point? Okay, that's another key element. So I into the water. And there's a foot of water below me and a foot of water above me. And I'm thinking, oh, this is bad. My dad is never gonna let me do anything again if I die in paradise. So I'm like, that's it. Okay, just move, right? Just move the body and get to the edge of the pool. Now, all of you real adults who were sitting around the pool were looking and kind of frowning and questioning, and my good friend Katie, who's just a slower than she used to be, goes, oh wait, this doesn't know how to swim. So she jumps in the pool. At this point, I'm like, move away, I am saving myself. Literally, that's what came out. So I grab onto the edge, right? And I am slowly walking myself to the ladder where I see, oh look, 7 feet. Oh, so I learned some important things, like make sure you look at all the writing around the pool before you get on the slide. Well, needless to say, I brought myself back to the United States after not dying in paradise, which was a good thing, and went to the YMCA, where I learned how to float and yell for help. I'm not a very proficient swimmer. Fast forward a couple years or so, and we decide we're going to go on another grown-up vacation, and this time it's like a real grown-up vacation. I've got a couple good girlfriends, and we're like, we're going to the beach. And I'm like, I almost drowned in paradise once, but the ocean's different. Let's go. So I'm standing, right, in this beautiful beach, Curie Beach, I believe, is in North Carolina. And the waves are just coming and crashing, and the kids are like jumping and they're swimming through, and it's so beautiful. And I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. So I walk into the ocean, and it's cold, and I'm like, you know, I'm fine. And I walk, and my good friend Tamika is like, jump in the wave. She's like, just jump. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna jump. And I go to jump, and I get hit in the face, like slapped down by the ocean. This happens several times before I just kind of lose my resolve and take myself out of the ocean and sit on the beach. But I learned a couple of very valuable things getting smacked down by the ocean. It's important for you to move through the breaks, right? Because so often I was getting stuck at home, feeling like I had to get away to have adventures and to have my life, because I got stuck. And I took that back with me. And then I came home, and I stopped letting home be this place of just overprotective nothingness. I moved through the break and got out into the open sea. Thank you.